Electrical. Your home's electrical system provides you with many conveniences that help you lead a normal day-to-day life. However, electrical currents are very dangerous and can cause burns, electric shock, and even death. Please use caution whenever dealing with electricity. If your home requires any electrical work that's not covered by our warranty, we recommend you hire a professional electrician. To help reduce the risk of electrocution, you should never allow any electrical devices to come close to water. For your own protection, avoid handling any electrical appliances, outlets, or your home circuit breaker box while wet or barefoot. In fact, rubber-soled shoes are the safest footwear when dealing with electricity. If there are any children in your home, you should use childproof outlet covers on all electrical outlets to provide protection from accidental shocks. Circuit breakers. Your home's electrical system is protected by circuit breakers that shut down or trip to protect against extensive electrical damage if a circuit becomes overloaded. The most common reason this happens is when too many electrical appliances are used in one outlet at the same time. Your system may also become overloaded if you plug in an appliance that has a defective power cord or that requires unusually great amounts of energy. By immediately shutting down electricity to outlets that have too much electrical current flowing through them, circuit breakers can help prevent fires or electrocution. As you can imagine, circuit breakers are one of the most important safety features in your home. If power goes off to a particular area in your home, you will want to correct the issue that may have tripped the breaker in the first place. Look around the area to see if there are an excessive number of appliances plugged into a particular outlet. Next, go to your electric service panel and find the breaker that serves the affected area. Push it all the way to the off position, and then push it back to on. This action will reset the breaker. If the power is off to your entire home, but the breaker switches are on, check outside and with your neighbors to determine if there's a loss of power to the entire neighborhood. In this situation, you will want to notify your local utility company. If the power loss is confined to your home and the breakers are on, we recommend that you shut down your main circuit breaker and contact a licensed electrician as you may have a serious problem. If your home is under warranty, use the emergency service procedure outlined in your home care manual. There's not a lot that's required to maintain your home circuit breaker box. You should make sure that you have easy access to it, so do not hide it behind paintings or other artwork. Also, to avoid dust buildup, you should regularly dust the circuit breakers using a can of compressed air. Wearing safety goggles while doing this task can help prevent dust particles from getting in your eyes. Ground fault circuit interrupters. In addition to the circuit breakers in the breaker box, your home has ground fault circuit interrupters, also known as GFCI or GFI outlets. These outlets are intended to provide extra safety where water is present. Your home is built in accordance with the National Electrical Code, which requires GFCI outlets in the kitchen, bathrooms, garage, and most outdoor receptacles. Keep in mind that one GFCI may control several outlets in one area of your home. Therefore, you may not see GFI controls on every outlet in these areas. To test the system, something you should do often, push the button marked T or test on the outlet. This will cut the power to the circuit and will shut down any appliances connected to the outlet. In order to restore the power, press the reset or R button until you hear a click. If the test indicates that the GFI is not working, you should have it looked at by a professional as soon as possible. Plugging refrigerators or freezers into a GFCI is not recommended, as a tripped GFCI will shut off power to the appliance, spoiling your food. In addition to GFI outlets, it's now a common practice to install arc fault circuit interrupters, or AFI outlets. These circuit breakers have the ability to detect if the cord plugged into the outlet is defective, possibly preventing fires from occurring. If an outlet is continually tripping, try plugging a different appliance into it with a different power cord. If this works, the power cord of the appliance that tripped the system may be defective. Switched outlets. Another great feature you will find throughout your home is a switched outlet, which is an electrical outlet controlled by a wall switch. This allows you to control appliances and lighting fixtures from one handy location. Many times, these outlets are positioned upside down to help you easily identify them. Because the electric current to a switched outlet is controlled from a wall switch, you should not connect any appliances that require a continuous supply of electricity, such as a refrigerator or a plug-in carbon monoxide detector, because of the consequences of accidentally turning off power to this outlet. Smoke and CO detectors. Smoke detectors and, if installed, carbon monoxide (CO) detectors are wired into your electrical system and should be tested often to ensure that the units are working properly. Follow the instructions in your unit's manual for directions on how to perform regular testing. During a power failure, the unit should continue to work on backup batteries. When these batteries need to be changed, the system will notify you by giving off a high-pitched chirping sound. However, we recommend changing these batteries once a year, regardless of whether or not the system is beeping. A great time to do this is during an important date that repeats itself on a yearly basis, such as a birthday or an anniversary. You should also refer to the manufacturer's manual for instructions on how to change your system's backup batteries. It's very important that you maintain your smoke detectors and, if installed, CO detectors in good working condition. These devices could save your life one day. The threat from carbon monoxide is especially great since you cannot see, smell, or taste it. Carbon monoxide is produced by the incomplete burning of materials that contain carbon, such as coal, wood, and gas, to name a few, which is another reason why it is particularly important to have your HVAC system inspected once a year by a qualified technician and to perform regular maintenance on such fuel-burning appliances as your home's HVAC, water heater, and fireplace if you have one. Proper ventilation is crucial, so make sure that appliances using combustible gases are well ventilated and kept clear of debris to help remove the carbon monoxide gas from inside your home. You should never use a charcoal grill indoors or a gas oven to heat your home, even for a short time. Also, never sleep in a room heated by a gas or kerosene space heater that does not have proper venting, or leave your car running inside your garage, especially if the garage door is closed, as asphyxiation can occur. While the number of carbon monoxide-induced deaths and hospital visits each year is relatively low, the thought of not being able to detect the toxin until it's too late should be enough reason to make sure your CO detector is working properly. If your carbon monoxide detector goes off, but you're feeling healthy, you should quickly open your windows to ventilate your home, turn off all potential sources of CO, then contact a qualified technician to check your fuel-burning appliances and chimney to ensure that they're working properly. If you experience headache along with nausea, fatigue, weakness, disorientation, or dizziness, this could be an indication that you're breathing in high levels of carbon monoxide. If you experience any of these symptoms, seek fresh air immediately and contact an emergency operator such as 911. Pre-wiring. Your home may be pre-wired for telephone, cable, internet, and home security. If you experience a problem with any of these systems, contact your service provider directly. If they determine that the problem is located inside your home, contact us and we will assist you.